This is the third video in the series Access Control API. In the previous video we showed the REST API, with which we were able to send commands to the AMS backend. The REST API can work with historical events that are already stored. This video will show the gRPC interface that can be used to receive live events from the AMS backend. For receiving these live events we need to use a gRPC client. In this video we will use the Kreya client. Kreya offers a free download for limited use. The installation of Kreya is easy and straightforward. The same conditions apply to the gRPC client Kreya as to the web tool Swagger in the previous video. We need to log in with a user with unlimited API rights. And we need a JSON file that determines whether that user is allowed to log in and for how long. After installation, we find the Kreya shortcut on our desktop. Let's start it. We will create a new project. We need to select a location and a name for it. The endpoint here is the gRPC backend service that listens to port 62998. We confirm the project setup. When the three Bosch services show up, we know that the connection has succeeded. The only command that we can perform without authentication and with positive result is get version. For all other commands, we first need to configure the authentication. So let's configure the authentication settings. OAuth2 is the industry standard protocol for authorization. In AMS that goes via the identity server on port 44333. We authorize with the user with unlimited API access that we created in preparation. Our scope is the product API and we authorize by access token, also called bearer token. That is a cryptic string sent by server after a successful login request. The token has a limited lifetime that can be configured in the JSON configuration file. The good thing of Kreya, in contrary to Swagger, is that it automatically refreshes the token. In the Bosch directory, we confirm the gRPC backend and add the just configured authorization settings. Now we need to receive the token from the identity server, and that token will be used during the complete session. After expiring, Kreya will automatically update the token. So now that the authorization has taken place, we can use the other commands. Let's ask for the events. These will be streamed and are always current. Coincidentally, Gianna Garcia just walked in. Her entrance results in two events. The first event tells us that she is leaving her current area, outside. The second event tells us that she has been given access to the next area, office building. Here are some more random examples of events that can occur and are reliably delivered by gRPC. Unauthorized door opening. Door is closed. Digital output is not set. More serious, connection is down. Fortunately, the connection has been restored. This concludes the third video in the Access Control API How-To series. In the next video, we will use the curl command line tool to work with REST API.